Welcome to the GSG Music Ultimate Music Theory Complete Supplemental Workbook Webinar. As teachers, we have many students, right, with different learning styles, abilities, and personalities. Am I right? And sometimes we find ourselves challenged with what is the most meaningful way to connect with a student and help them grow to their full potential as a musician. And I want you to meet the Ultimate Music Theory family, Sola and Tito. And think about which one best describes you. Meet Sola. Now, Sola loves to sing and dance, and she is expressive, creative, and loves to tell stories through music. Now, Sola feels music in her heart, and she loves to teach, and compose, and perform. Now, meet Tito. Tito loves to count and march. He's rhythmic, consistent, and he loves the rules of music theory. And Tito feels music in his hands and feet, and he loves to analyze and share tips and conduct. Together, Sola and Tito will guide you through mastering music theory. So question, are you a Sola or a Tito? Go ahead and enter that in the chat box. Are you a Sola or a Tito? Now, I am definitely a Sola, and sometimes even a super Sola, which can get me into trouble, ha ha ha, which is why I am so happy that Sheila is a Tito. And together, we balance each other out, and we love writing and creating and you know, getting all kinds of teaching materials together for you. So I'm Glory Sola St. Germain with Sheila Tito McKibben Urin, and together we've created the Ultimate Music Theory Program. And now that you know about our personalities, what about you? Remember, I want to know about you too. Are you a Sola or a Tito? And again, just throw that in the chat box and let me know. At times, we can be a little bit of both as needed, but I think for the most part, are you a Sola or are you a Tito? And I'm definitely a Sola, and Sheila's definitely a Tito. When the 2016 Royal Conservatory of Music Theory syllabus came out, other than being completely overwhelmed with all this new material, Sheila and I decided it was time to build on the Ultimate Music Theory series and develop the UMT Supplemental series. And we're so glad we did. We put together the UMT Dream Team, and together with Sola and Tito, we want to thank three Ultimate Music Theory certified teachers for their contributions to the supplemental series. So in the front row, starting on the left, is Julianne Workington, our Ultimate Piano Series composer, Ruth Douglas, our Harmony History and Analysis Consultant, and Joanne Barker, our Ultimate Music Theory Games Creator. The UMT workbooks plus the UMT supplemental workbooks equal the RCM, the Royal Conservatory of Music Theory, levels. So to date, we've covered Prep 1, used with the Prep level and Level 1 supplemental, Prep 2, used with Level 2, followed by Level 3, Basic, used with Level 4, followed by Level 5, Intermediate, used with Level 6, followed by Level 7, Advanced Rudiments, which is done together with Level 8. And today, and thank you for joining me today, we are presenting the All-in-One Complete Rudiments Workbook together with the All-in-One Complete Supplemental Workbook. And these workbooks help students prepare for nationally recognized theory exams, including the RCM Level 8 theory exam and college entrance exams and so on. And they just really are to build musicianship skills. Because at Ultimate Music Theory, we take complicated concepts and we make it easy and fun. Now, in today's session, you will learn about the Complete Rudiments Workbook plus the Complete Supplemental Workbook. So we're going to do these together. Now, each workbook has a handy matching answer book that is identical to the workbook. And this makes marking really quick and easy and honestly saves you hours of time. And I know, because I'm a teacher too. Now, these workbooks are completed together at the same time and prepare students for that RCM Theory Level 8 exam. Now, that was previously called the Advanced Rudiments exam, so now it's called Level 8. Now, the complete workbooks are designed for the accelerated learner, and they're honestly a must-have resource for your teaching studio because it's the all-in-one book. The complete supplemental workbook includes all the theory concepts, the melody writing, and the music history from all the previous levels. UMT Complete Supplemental, LOL, and we are certainly doing that. Listen, organize, learn. A proven step-by-step system. And are you ready to LOL? Okay, go ahead and say yes, I am in the chat box. We're all together. Awesome. So put a big smile on your face and an LOL in the chat box, and let's get started. At UMT, we've got you covered. And today we're going to talk about the complete supplemental, what's new, plus you definitely will LOL, learn, master techniques, organize, simple steps, listen to music genres, and a UMTC success story from our very special guest, Ultimate Music Theory certified teacher, Camara Hennessy. And by the way, she is definitely a Sola, as you will see. The Complete Rudiments workbook contains 12 lessons with a comprehensive review test at the end of each lesson. Now, the complete supplemental workbook correlates to each of the 12 lessons in the Complete Rudiments workbook, with the table of contents outlining the concepts and the music history introduced in each lesson. So we have our overview comparison chart, and each lesson correlates. So lesson one, lesson two, three, and so on. The music history introduced in each lesson covers all the levels, including prep and the levels 1 to 8. And then we've also included that bonus of the level 8 theory exam and a special certificate because we want to recognize our students for their accomplishments, right? The complete comparison chart maps out the RCM level 8 theory concepts with the complete supplemental workbook. And the supplemental workbook pages are indicated with a little star as the new concepts are introduced in the 2016 RCM theory syllabus. Now, we've created amazing resources for you and your students to watch all the videos for the history. Plus, if you don't already have the Ultimate Music Theory app, you can see it there on the right at the bottom of the page. You may want to get that. The Ultimate Music Theory app contains over 7,000 flashcards. Sheila and I had an absolute blast putting that together for you, and it includes audio to help you learn faster. And my students absolutely love it. It's definitely something you want to have in your studio, and you can use it on your PC, on your mobile device, on your iPad, on any electronic device. So it's really handy, and it syncs all your lessons so you can keep track of your progress. Now, whether you are Tito sitting on the piano bench or Solas sharpening your pencil, grab your complete UMT workbooks and get ready to LOL. LOL Complete Supplemental starts with number one, learn master techniques for melody writing. And we'll start with the Complete Rudiments workbook on page 200. Now, here you're learning about the 5-7 chord, a dominant triad plus a minor seventh as used in an authentic cadence. When a dominant seventh chord is used in a perfect cadence, now referred to as an authentic cadence, the fifth note above the dominant may be omitted. The 5-7 chord always contains the added seventh note. And in an authentic cadence, also known as a perfect cadence, when the 5-7 chord is used, the seventh note hugs the dominant note. So we can kind of recognize it pretty easy. Say hi to my student Carter. As we review cadences on page 200 of the Complete Rudiments workbook, and you will notice that I ask a lot of questions so that Carter can verbalize his thought process. Very important. While watching Carter throughout this presentation, I want you to observe his personality. Do you think he's a Sola or a Tito? And I'll reveal the answer a little bit later. But first, let's get started with the Complete Rudiments Workbook, page 200. Here's Carter.
Well, we're with Carter today, and he's doing the complete supplemental workbook and the complete rudiments workbook. Wow, double dose, Carter. Nice work. I know they're both thick books,
that
right?
Is a thick book.
They're really thick books. Okay, well, go ahead and open up your complete workbook because today, and we are on what page, Carter?
We're on page 200.
Page 200. Oh my gosh. And we've been talking about authentic cadences and half cadences. And today we're going to take a look at the authentic cadence. So it's also called the perfect cadence. Now, what's different about this? Sort of give me the options here, Carter, on what is an authentic cadence. What do we look for?
Well, in an authentic cadence, typically the chords, well, not structure, but the change, it would go from 5-1, so the dominant to the tonic,
right?
Or if it's a 5-7 cadence, it'll go from 5-7 to 1.
Excellent. Okay, so can you go ahead and play them for me? What key are you playing the first group in?
I am playing the first group in D major.
D major. So the first one is the authentic cadence as a 5-1. So let's go ahead and hear that one. Okay, and now we're going to change that up and play a 5-7-1. So what is the difference between a 5 and a 5-7?
Well, in a regular 5 chord, there are only typically 3 notes to it, and it would be the 1, 3, 5. Okay? Well,
right.
I guess it would be this, because
right.
We're in
mm-hmm.
D. In the 5-7, we add that minor 7th to it. So it would be more A, C sharp, B, G.
Excellent.
So
good.
When we play the cadence here, we just take out the E and play the A, the C, and the G. So we end up with this. And then to the one.
Right. Nice work. All right. So now, thank you.
Oh, thank you.
You're a good teacher. So now we're going to have a listen to the next one. This is in the key of D minor. So again, we've got a 5-1 cadence. Let's play that one first. Wow, that sounds so different, doesn't it? And then the 5-7-1. Now, I see that there is an uppercase letter for the 5, even though we're in a minor key. So when we see the functional chord symbols, what do the uppercase and lowercase stand for?
Well, 5 is always a major key. It doesn't matter if you're playing in a major key or a minor key. The 5 will always be major.
Correct.
So if you're playing in D major, this is your 5. And if you're playing in D minor, this is also your 5 because of that raised 7th note here.
Excellent.
But the tonic changes. If we have an uppercase I, we're in a major key. And if we have a lowercase I, we're in a minor key. So if we're in a major key, that would be our uppercase I, but if we're in the minor key and there's a lowercase level I, the letter I, it would sound more minor.
Yeah, really great job. So now we're going to take a look at melody writing using our perfect cadences, also called authentic cadences, with the 5-1 and the 5-7-1 chords. Are you ready for that one?
I think so.
Let's do it.
Master techniques for melody writing. In the complete supplemental workbook on page 103, at the top of the page, you will see melody writing, parallel period, harmonic progression, use after page 200. Now, a harmonic progression or chord progression is the foundation of harmony that establishes the tonality or key of the piece and supports the melody. Now, chord progressions may be indicated by Roman numerals called functional chord symbols, and they're usually written below the staff. Now, in the example box, the parallel period contains both the 5 chord and the 5-7 chord. So you can see them there. The first one is the 5-7 chord, followed by the 5 chord. And this is called the harmonic progression. Listen as Carter explores the master techniques for melody writing in the complete supplemental workbook on page 103.
Okay, Carter, so now we're going to go into the complete Rudiments workbook and turn over to the page 103. So we've done the complete Rudiments. Now we're in the supplemental book. Yay, Carter.
I'm so happy right now.
I like it when you're happy. You're so fun to teach. So today we're talking about the harmonic progression or chord progression that is found within the parallel period. So what does Sola say?
Sola says, a disjunct melody may outline the notes of a chord. A conjunct melody may include non-triad notes or passing tones, PT labeled, that connect triad tones with stepwise motion.
Very well said. So let's take a look at the music. In the first measure, is that actually going to be a disjunct melody or is that conjunct melody?
It is going to be a disjunct melody.
Okay, how do you know that? What does that mean?
Well, a disjunct melody is a movement or a change in movement in a measure, let's say, that is changed by steps or leaps.
Correct.
So,
of the chord.
You're right.
Okay, so now what about the other definition there that we had was a conjunct melody. So if we're looking in measure 1, 2, 3, we see a PT in there. And what is a PT exactly?
Well, a passing tone is a note in between two notes of a chord.
Very good.
So if a disjunct melody is moving by steps, then the conjunct, or not steps, but skips and leaps, then the conjunct melody is being moved by steps.
Very good. Well said. All right, so now let's take a look at the melody, and I'd like you to go ahead and play that. So we see that we have functional chord symbols below, and we're just going to play the root note of each one of them while you're playing the melody. So this is called a parallel period. So we're going to play it first, and then we're going to do a little analysis about it. So go ahead and play that for us, Carter.
Okay.
Now, when we're looking at the melody, how can you tell that it is a parallel period? What do you notice about the measures?
Well, when you look at the first two measures in both phrases, they are identical with one another. Parallel meaning identical.
Right. Same direction, right? Okay. And when we look at the last two measures, are they the same or different?
Well, they are different, but they have the same idea to them. They have the first three notes going in the contrary motion.
Right. Okay, and how are we ending the first four bar phrase?
We're ending it with a imperfect or half cadence, if you
Right.
will.
Okay, and then the final measure is with a.
Is with a authentic or perfect cadence.
Excellent. Okay, good job on that.
In the complete supplemental workbook on page 104, the instructions indicate to observe the chord symbols. Notice that the functional chord symbols below each exercise are the same. Right? Does that make sense? When we look at the answer book on page 104, notice that although the functional chord symbols are the same, the root quality chord symbols written above the staff are different as they're based on the key of the melody. And in the answer pages, we notice the same functional chord symbols with different melodic lines above the harmonic progression. So just because we have the same functional chord symbols doesn't mean that we have the same melodic line. Does that make sense? Listen as Carter reviews the functional and root quality chord symbols at the top of page 104.
We're talking about same and different. So we can have the same functional chord symbols as we're seeing in the example 1-4-5-1, that's 5-7, but the bass note is still 5. And then the next one says 1-4-5-1 as well. So we have the same functional chord symbols used for different melodies. So let's go ahead and listen to the 1-4-5-1 for those two. So we have two different keys, C major and F major. So go ahead and play the C major first.
Okay. Next key is F major.
Okay, so let's do F major. Very good. So was the root quality, or sorry, functional chord symbol the same?
It was.
Yes, so we're just going for the same 1-4-5-1. Okay, now let's play the melody and see if they're the same. Next one in F major. So was the melody the same or different?
The melody was different.
Different, but the functional chord symbols
were the same.
Were the same. And then we see our root quality chord symbols above the music, and obviously they are based on the same functional chord symbols, but they're different because they're in different
keys.
Different keys. Nice.
LOL complete supplemental number 2. Organize simple steps to excel in your studies. Now, throughout the Ultimate Music Theory Pro Workbook program, we have organized simple steps to help you excel in your studies. At the back of each Rudiments workbook is the Ultimate Music Theory chart, and this includes the circle of fifths with major keys on the outside of the circle and relative minor keys on the inside of the circle. And this is what I call the open circle of fifths, where you can clearly see each key and its key signature. Now, throughout the UMT series, you will also find mnemonic devices or memory joggers to help you easily identify concepts, such as the image mnemonics for the harmonic and melodic minor scales. So harmonic and melodic minor scales. And these organized memory joggers with simple steps will help you to excel in your studies. So here's Carter hanging out with his friend Sol and Tito, and he's about to reveal if he's more like Sola or more like Tito. Which one do you think he is? Go ahead and put your answer in the chat box. Is he more like Sola or more like Tito? I'm really interested to see what you think. Okay, let's go ahead and see what they're up to.
Well, there's Sol and Tito, and there's Carter. What's going on?
Just reflecting how to do my theory.
Anybody helping you out today?
Oh, I've got my good friends Sol and Tito.
Do you? Okay, so are you more like a Sola, or are you more like a Tito?
Well, I'd have to say I'm definitely more like Tito. While Sola loves to sing and dance, Tito loves to count and march, and Tito loves to tap, and I'm a bass player in jazz, too, and tapping and counting is really most of what I do. So I think that Tito and I relate very well with one another.
That's great. I totally think you guys are buds forever. So you are getting organized, and as a bass player and section leader, and you've accomplished a lot of things. You've been a musician of the year and won gold and festivals, and in addition to playing the piano, playing the bass. You're quite amazing.
And thank you.
Yeah, and I know that theory has helped you a lot. And so tell me some of the things that maybe help you get organized when you're preparing for an exam, and in particular in the theory. So what have you got going on here?
Well, when I'm preparing for a theory exam, I like to start with making my circle of fifths.
All right.
Now, we've already started with the major keys here. And we have my flats and my sharps. So we'll just go through the minor keys really quickly.
All right.
So we start at 4. We go with our F, C,
Father Charles goes
down, and ends battle. Mm-hmm. And we start with Father. That's a lowercase F. Mm-hmm. Charles.
Sharp.
Go sharp. Down sharp.
Mm-hmm.
And sharp. Coming to left field here with the N
and flat.
And then N's flat. And paddle flat.
Excellent. So when you're looking at the complete workbook and you're looking at the Ultimate Music Theory chart on the back, I see that we've got some memory joggers there, and we also call those mnemonic devices. So what's going on with your H and your M? What does that kind of help you remember?
Well, the H with the little seven hidden in here,
mm-hmm.
It represents a harmonic minor scale. So we know from a harmonic minor that we go up, we raise the seventh on the way up and the way down. And so that's why we have the arrows pointing up and the seven hidden in here.
All right.
Now for the M over here, the M stands for melodic, and we have our little six and seven in between. Now we go our arrows up because we raise the sixth and seventh on the way up,
mm-hmm.
and we put our arrows down as well, going down, because you lower the six and seven on the way down.
Excellent. Well, that's a really, really good memory jogger.
In continuing the simple steps to excel in your studies, another question that students often struggle with is learning the terms of harmonic and melodic intervals. Now, here we've used image mnemonics, a visual memory jogger for the harmonic interval and for the melodic interval. That makes it really easy to remember and associate the image mnemonic to the meaning of the word. As you look at it, you can see how simple that is, right? Do you see how simple it is? Excellent. Let's check in with Carter on his H and M, harmonic and melodic memory joggers.
So now we talked about the harmonic and melodic scales, and now let's talk about harmonic and melodic intervals, because right now we want to organize and really find successful tools for remembering things. So when you look at the H and the M, how do you remember this, Carter?
Well, a good way for remembering it for me is that intervals make me tired. So the way I see it, you have the Harmony Hotel and the Melody Motel.
All right.
So harmonic intervals
right.
are seen as one note on top of the other one.
All right, beautiful.
They are played together, so it would sound more like that if you had a C and an E.
Right.
Now for the Melody Motel, if it's a melodic interval, you have one note just hanging out over here,
mm-hmm.
and you have another note hanging out over here or down here, depending on where you want it.
And what is that called?
Well, that would be a melodic interval, so mm-hmm. it'd be played separately, so it'd sound more like this.
Beautiful. And so that's what's really creating the melody, and the harmonic interval is what's creating the harmony.
Wow.
Wow, we're good. All right, let's check this out.
Mnemonic devices are memory jogger techniques that you can use to help you improve your ability to remember something. In other words, it's a memory technique to help your brain better encode and recall important information. Now, in the Complete Rudiments workbook, you are learning about modes. A mode is a scale that has the same pattern of tones and semitones as a major scale. And each mode begins on a different scale degree of the major scale. Does that make sense? Okay. A simple mnemonic device is using the UMT hint sentence. I do play like Mozart and Liszt. And this now will help you remember the order and the names of the modes. How simple is that, right? Here's Carter using the mnemonic device of the hint sentence and his fingers, as you can see, to identify the mode. So let's watch how he does it. And remember, he's a Tito.
So on page 71 in the Complete Rudiments workbook, we're learning about modes and how we organize sort of our modes. And an easy way to remember is we actually have a little hint sentence. I do play like Mozart and Liszt. Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, Mixolydian, Aeolian, and Locrian. That's a big thing there. So walk me through how you're going to determine what is the mode, Carter, of the scale that we see at the bottom of the page.
Well, judging by the first note that we can determine is a G, we know that the scale starts on G.
Okay.
So then we look at the key signature. We don't have any sharps or flats.
Okay.
And a mode is a scale, a major scale.
Correct.
It has to be a major scale.
Yes.
That is played on a certain degree.
Good job.
So a scale, a major scale with no sharps or flats would be C major. So let's count backwards from G. G, F, E, D, C.
Okay.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I do play like Mozart. So this is a Mixolydian scale. So it sounds something like this.
Excellent. And does anyone ever write music in the Mixolydian mode?
Yes.
All the time,
all the
right?
Time.
All the time.
Many songs are based off of modes.
They are.
LOL, complete supplemental number 3 is listen. Music genres change what we hear. Throughout the complete supplemental series, you are learning about music history. And when we listen to music, music genres change what we hear. Music history through the ages has evolved in both sacred and secular music. The elements of music in melody, harmony, rhythm, dynamics, texture, phrasing, and voicing continue to develop, creating new sounds. So various music genres are heard throughout the medieval, Renaissance, Baroque, and classical eras. And I've just listed a few examples below that. Music history continues to be written using new styles of electronic music and electronic instruments, of course. The influences of global music fused into the modern genres produce the unique musical sounds of tomorrow. And musical genres continue to evolve through the romantic, modern, and global music styles. And again, I've listed just a few examples there below for you. Now, here's the done-for-you, really fun part of the Ultimate Music Theory program. When you go to gsgmusic.com or ultimatemusictheory.com, same thing, simply click on the free resources at the top of the page, and then scroll down to find the complete, and then simply click View Page. The free resources for the complete supplemental workbook are mapped out according to the pages in the workbook that correspond to the videos for each supplemental workbook level. So when doing the exercises in the complete supplemental workbook, pages 148 to 157, the videos correspond to the level 7 supplemental workbook presenting Stravinsky, Hugh LaCaine, and Duke Ellington. So simply click on the link to watch the videos. It's that simple. Now here's Carter walking us through the listening activity in the complete supplemental workbook, pages 154 and 155, while listening to Duke Ellington's Coco. Now listen carefully as Carter is counting the bars and recognizing the 12-bar blues structure of Coco. Now, if you're a sola like me, put your hands in the air and get up and dance. And if you're a Tito like Carter, tap and count and find your groove, baby. Enjoy the genre of the jazz big band with Duke Ellington's Coco. Now, the most fun about music is listening to it and playing it. And we can really tell the elements of jazz. So what are some of the things, and you play a lot of jazz because you
do.
Play bass and play piano. And so tell me some of the elements of jazz.
Well, some of the elements of jazz are syncopation, rhythmic pulse, known as swing, and improvisation are some of the biggest factors in jazz music.
Very cool. I think we should have a little listen to some of this. So this is a 12-bar blues by Duke Ellington, and we've kind of itemized it here, which is a really cool thing, because when you go to the Ultimate Music Theory free resources, we've kind of got it all lined up for you. So Coco by Duke Ellington, and I think we're just going to actually have a listen to the whole piece, and I'm going to have you kind of point to us so we know there's... 12-bar blues, and we can see repeated bars, first bar intro 8, and then 12, 12, 12, 12. And also, what instruments are we hearing while we're listening to that music? So let's have some fun and listen to this one.
All right. This is Coco by Duke Ellington and his famous orchestra.
All right.
Alright, so just a nice little 8-bar intro. Now we're in a bit of a valve trombone solo in the first chorus. Now entering the second chorus here, there's a muted trombone solo that you can really tell the difference between that and the valve trombone. In this third chorus, still a muted trombone, but there's a different sound to it. It's a much, much tighter sound, really. Now we have the man, Duke Ellington himself, in the fourth chorus playing a little piano solo here. In the fifth chorus, we have three trumpet players all playing in unison here. Baseline. Now we've got the full ensemble playing together, so it really produces that balance, that sound that you really like here. After all those 12-bar ideas, we just go back into a little coda, which is just kind of similar to the introduction, so...
Kind of wrapping it all up.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So, you know, we've got our solo antinos just kind of hanging out.
Great job. Thanks, Carter.
You know, my journey began as a nervous piano teacher, looking like a deer in the headlights when thinking about music theory and all the concepts I had to figure out and learn, and then learn how to teach them, not to mention all the changes that were evolving ahead of me. Through years of research and development, the UMT teaching philosophy is something I truly wanted to share in helping you teach with passion, so you wouldn't have to go through all the years of frustration that I did. Together, we are enriching lives through music education, which is why we created the Ultimate Music Theory Certification Course for you. Our UMT success story is Ultimate Music Theory Certified Teacher Kamara Hennessy, who immigrated to Canada from Trinidad, and she is definitely a creative sola. From traveling to Venice, to learning to play the saxophone in addition to teaching piano, to inspiring her student Tommy to begin melody writing on his UMT whiteboard. Kamara is a fun, inspiring music teacher who is open to learning new things and sharing ideas, and I'm very grateful for those ideas she shared with me. Here is Camara and her experience with Ultimate Music Theory.
Hi, I'm Camara Hennessy, and I'm from Burlington, Ontario. And I'm so pleased to be here to give my thoughts on the UMT course. As you see, I have some of the resources behind me. I was first introduced to this resource back in 2010 or 12, maybe 2012, when Gloria St. Germain came to Ontario and did a workshop. And subsequently, I was contacted again to view her video on the course system that she was offering online. And after viewing it, I thought this sounded really interesting, and I decided I was going to invest in her course. And I am so glad I've done this, you know, this investment, because I think it's one of the best, well-planned, laid-out course that her and her team has developed, and to date has really given a lot of information into from a pedagogical point of view in how to teach it very effectively to our students. I've used many resources out there before, in preparation for my students to do the Royal Conservatory exam. But I found Glory's Ultimate Music Theory book designed in such a way that it's really well laid out in every chapter of the workbook for the students. And most of all, she has provided us with additional resources over the years to help us build on our experience, our learning and teaching experience, through the videos that she's have available on her website. So for that, I'm so grateful to have had that, and she's so generous to offer us those resources to ourselves and to our students. One of the things I like about this whole system that she's put in place is the fact that she's put things to make it fun and enjoyable for the student, as well as the teachers, to have fun working along with the student through the games and through things like my little friends here, Tito and Sola, which my students love, even my adult students, really love when they have a good lesson session. We always do a little high five and talk about, you know, their role in the learning experience. I have fun with doing it. So I do want to say how I am so delighted to know that there is such a effective resource that Ultimate Music Theory has developed for us teachers and for students to work on. And most of all, the supplementary a resource that she has put together, her and her team, Gloria and her team, put together to help with move currently with the Royal Conservatory change, using the her what we call her supplemental level. I have here a copy of the level one supplemental, and working through that along with the workbook has really helped to make the learning process quite easy and systematic. I like the way it's systematic. It progresses in a very clear, concise way. And all the tips and tricks that she has let us use in that, you know, in her resource is really, really helpful. It makes for a fun learning and teaching experience. So I would really like to thank Glory, Sheila, and the rest of her team for doing such a marvelous job with the UMT and bringing this resource to us teachers to help us to become better at what we do and how effective we can teach, and to continue that NEPD philosophy that Glory, you know, forever continues to emphasize for us. So for those of you who are looking and taking part in her webinar, I would strongly recommend and encourage you to continue learning, growing, and you know, use the resources that she has. And I'm so delighted to be here to help say how wonderful a program this is for us as teachers and students. So, bye.
The one and only Ultimate Music Theory Certification Course for Teachers, your pedagogical teacher training. Now you can learn easily in your own home at your own tempo. Save years of time in one step-by-step online course and get certified with the UMTC Professional Development Program. You've often heard me talk about NEPD, Never Ending Professional Development, and I myself am always a student, continuing to learn always and then share my research and my developments with you. The UMTC course will give you the secret to understand learning styles and rapport building techniques, master neurolinguistic programming to create successful relationships, not only with your students, but with your spouse, with your children, with your friends, and your family too. Teach basic, intermediate, and advanced rudiments with massive success. We give you all those tools. And finally, to create financial freedom with done-for-you marketing to grow your studio, because you are an independent business owner. So go to ultimatemusictheorycourse.com for all the details. And as you can see, Sheila and I, along with Solentito, are there to support you all the way. Through the years, thousands of music teachers have found massive success in their teaching as they use the proven step-by-step system of the Ultimate Music Theory program. The Ultimate Music Theory Certification Course is an online teacher training program that will truly elevate your professional development. I'm so confident that you will achieve successful pedagogical teaching results using the 17 teaching skills, rapport building techniques, and understanding learning styles, that I'm going to give you a 30-day, 100% money-back guarantee. If you don't learn anything when taking the Ultimate Music Theory Certification course, simply contact us and we will refund your course fee. You've nothing to lose and everything to gain. Here's to your teaching success. You can get started today. You can call us toll-free, 1-800-520-4680. Again, 1-800-520-4680. So no more formatas, no more excuses. You can do this, and we are here to help you every step of the way. So get certified. Call or go to ultimatemusictheorycourse.com today. I'm Glory St. Germain. I should say I'm Glory Sola St. Germain, and I'll see you on the inside. Till next time, teach with passion.